Good morning. It is day one of mid-month book bash for September.
It is Friday and it's about 10 o'clock. My day has already started. I already had a presentation that I had to do this morning, and then after that, I went and took a shower, got all nice and clean. Bonus points of work from home is that when you have an early presentation, you can't fake it on camera and then actually go and take a shower later instead of having to get up extra early to get all, you know. Anyways, so mid-month book bash is here. This weekend snuck up on me. I think that's a product of having been sick for 2 weeks, feeling much better right now. So thank you for all your well wishes in my TBR video. What was I gonna say? So the other thing is, like, how are 4-day weeks always the ones that feel the longest? Because this is a 4-day work week and it feels really long, but it's Friday. So that is exciting. As far as what I will be reading this weekend, I started like the first few pages of The Feeling of Falling in Love by Mason Deaver a couple of days ago, and so far liking it. I'm only like 7 pages in, but Mason Deaver's writing is really great. I love their other book. I wish you all the best. I haven't read the one that came after that, which was The Ghosts We Keep, because that book was apparently about grief, and I just didn't feel prepared to read that at the moment that it was published. So I will probably end up getting that one if I really like this one, because I do think that Mason Deaver has a potential to be a favorite author of mine. So yes, this is what I am currently reading in the physical form. And then in terms of audiobooks, I am still listening to the audiobook of Tomorrow and Tomorrow and Tomorrow by Gabriel Zevin, and I'm at basically the 50% mark of this, and I'm enjoying this, but I feel like when this first came out, it was talked about in one way, and then now as more people read it, the conversation around it has changed a bit. People are still universally loving this. I've seen maybe one or two people who didn't really love it, but in general, it's still getting really high praise. And this was sent to me by Knopf, and I also had a Libro FM ARC of this, so that's what I'm listening to the audiobook through. But I don't know. Like, the stuff about the game is really interesting. So the whole premise of this book is that we have two main characters, Sadie and Sam, and they've known each other basically their whole lives. They have kind of like a history. Their friendship has a history, and then they end up meeting again many years later and creating a game called Ichigo together. And this follows. Oh, sorry, I suddenly had to sneeze. But this follows them in like the game creation and their lives around that time period. And we're kind of at like the, I don't know what section it is. It's sectioned out, so I think it may be section 4? Yeah, I'm in section 4. And they're creating a new game now. And there's just a lot of trauma and just like shitty things that happen in this book. And I don't know. Like, I feel like this was billed to me originally as like this fun friendship slash love, like, love story, friendship story, about friends, about friendship, found family, video game culture. And it's much more like, I don't know, I can't describe it. I saw a couple people say that it was like A Little Life Light. I haven't read A Little Life, and I probably never will. Doesn't interest me whatsoever. But I do feel like I can understand from what I know about that book where that comparison is coming from. And that's what I think I'm struggling with, is that that part of the book, like, it's as important as the game and friendship story. I don't know, I'm just not talking about this right. Like, I appreciate the picture of disability and of mental health and the complicated nature of relationships, but there's just something about this that doesn't draw me in repeatedly. So, like, I don't, like, when I get in the car, I don't immediately want to turn my audiobook on and start listening, which is a shame. So I went, like, maybe 2 whole weeks without listening to this because I didn't leave the house. So I think that might be part of the problem, is that I was listening to it every day and then I took a 2-week break from it, and now I don't feel as connected to the characters or the story anymore. So we'll see. I know, so I will, I'm finally allowed to leave the house, and I will be going a couple of places on Sunday, and then I have to go into the office Monday, Tuesday. So I will get quite a bit of listening to this done. So I'm hoping that I will kind of, like, rekindle my appreciation for this book in that time, and also that I will finish it up so that I can move on to a different audiobook. But that's my thoughts so far on this one. And I did realize that I didn't actually tell you what this one is about. And that's because I don't really know. This is another, like, friendship love story situation. The first chapter, our main character is, like, hanging out with his friends with benefits, and then his friends with benefits tells him he loves him, and then it's like everything spirals out of control from there. And that's really all I know about it. So we'll see how this goes. I do think that Mason Deaver tends to write some messy relationships. So yeah, those are the books that I am working on right now, and hopefully, so if I, we'll see how I do with those. I want to start Go Tell It on the Mountain next week, so I'm hoping to get a fair amount through this, if not finish this, so that I can start Go Tell It on the Mountain. Quite bright outside. Just checking out the state of the garden. The zucchinis, yeah, the zucchinis died. They got, what are those called? Little larvae, the squash vine borer larvae. They bit the dust. So we had a lot of zucchini early on, and then no zucchini. So that's a lesson for next year. I'm gonna have to do some more research on the best ways to combat that. Our one tomato plant that ended up being a cherry tomato plant is pretty scraggly. We're also not really using a lot of the cherry tomatoes, so I'm probably going to get out here either this evening or this weekend and get rid of that. So cut it off at the base and do away with all the rest of it. We don't have a compost pile, which I would love to have a compost pile, so I think that is definitely a goal for next year, is to have an actual compost pile. The watermelon still is trying to do its thing, but I'm also probably going to pull that all out as well. The only things that I am planning on leaving are the peppers. They are still growing pretty well, and actually the bell peppers didn't do so well early season, but are doing great right now. So I'm gonna leave the peppers and the herbs. So the basil is still wildly successful, by far my most successful thing all season. So I'm gonna leave all of that,
and then I'm gonna prep the rest of the bed for fall planting. So I am gonna come through with some seeds for lettuce and plant those. That I think I can just direct sow the lettuce seeds and that won't be an issue. And then I am hoping to maybe go to the garden center later on in the week. In the weekend. So maybe Sunday, and pick up some fall plants. So potentially like broccoli or something like that. So that is the garden plan right now. I came out here to see if I could do anything with it on my lunch break. Strawberry plants look great. That one over there is like a mega producer. The rest of these haven't done nearly as well. This one has some runners, so that's part of it, but I am mostly just letting them kind of like establish themselves, because supposedly year two is when you really see strawberries produce like rapidly. And for the winter, I'm going to be planting garlic down in here. So when I overwinter these, I will also plant garlic. And so that bed will get some use over the winter while nothing's really growing.
I'm sitting still in my driveway, just FYI. But my day is done. I feel very tired. That is one thing from being sick that has carried over a little bit, is feeling pretty wiped out after the day, at the end of the day, which I don't usually feel. And then kind of a lingering cough. But I'm finally feeling like an actual normal human again. For the most part. So that's really nice. So I'm going to pick up the little one and then just hang out until it's time for bed, in about 2 hours for him. And then, yeah. Trying to get some reading in tonight. We'll see how that happens. I also need to mop the kitchen floor tonight because it is filthy.
I'm exhausted. Oh my gosh. I think it's a combination of like just really starting to feel better, but still like 2 p.m. I get the urge to just lay down in my bed, and I usually do take the urge because I almost always feel better after like maybe 15 minutes of laying down. Twice this week I laid down and closed my eyes and like set a safety alarm and definitely woke up to my safety alarm. So thankful for that flexibility in my job, that like falling asleep for 15 minutes is not a big deal. But yeah, I'm wiped. It's also been a mentally taxing week. We're going into our busiest season, and so I just haven't had the time nor the energy for a lot of things. I still have to film something in terms of a video to put up for Sunday, because I haven't done that, and I'm not actually sure when I'm gonna do that. I need to do that, so I'll probably try to squeeze in a review video, because that's something that I have the thoughts in my head, and I just need to gather up the books that go with that video, and then I could just like do that anywhere in the house, potentially while Grayson is napping. Whereas any of the other things I kind of have slated to do videos on would take a lot more prep and a lot more mental energy, which I just don't have. Plain and simple. So that is it right now. I have been, I started my Animal Crossing Island over again. So I have been playing Animal Crossing once a day, and it's been really nice. It feels nostalgic in the way that, like, when I was pregnant and I couldn't sleep, I'll wake up at like 4:35 in the morning and go downstairs and play Animal Crossing. Like it was like roughly 4:35 in the morning because it was like when the day flipped over. So like I'd be playing at like the tail end of the night before, and then when the day started over for the next day. And I remember like all the soft 5 a.m. music, which is probably my favorite of the Animal Crossing music. But yeah, so that was something, the early days of like the Animal Crossing playthrough, so like the part where you're actually having to do things before you have all of the shops open and your villagers and all of that. That's very like nostalgic of early 2020 pregnant Jenny. So yeah, it's fun. It's really been a nice playthrough, and the last couple of times I played Animal Crossing, I did like the time travel thing because I was like building a themed island and I wanted it to be a certain way, and so I didn't want to wait. Which was fun, and I really enjoyed building out like little spaces and stuff. But after a while, I just sort of like burnt out on that. And my Switch stopped letting me time travel. It like stopped letting me change the date at some point. It like got really glitchy, and I feel like that was just a sign that I just needed to slow down and play the game a slower pace. So that's what I'm doing this time around. And then I haven't read any more in my book, this one, but I did listen to some more of my audiobook in the car, and my feelings have thus far not changed. So yeah, that is it. As far as like a reading kind of day update, Grayson was extremely tired when he got home today, and so everything was kind of making him mad, and he was upset about a lot of things. But we got him back in his routine now, so he's been a lot more I say manageable, and I don't mean that in like, oh, manage your child. I just mean that like when he was out of his routine for like 3 weeks, it was just kind of a difficult time because you could tell that it was just something didn't feel right to him. You know, he was getting up a lot later and he wasn't going to Nana's every day, and it was just very off for him, and you could tell in the way that he was kind of behaving. And so it's been interesting to see that like that routine is really important for him as much as it is important for us. So I'm glad to have him back on his routine. He got new jammies today and he was thrilled. I told him after I put him in him, I was like, "Do you want to go show Daddy your new jammies?" And he said, "Yeah, they're really cool," and ran down the hall to show them to Daddy. So that was precious. But yeah, he's sleeping, and Justin is getting up with him in the morning, and I am gonna try my best to be able to just like lay in bed for like 30, 40 minutes in the morning, maybe read a couple of pages, instead of getting up and going downstairs, because I need it. I need the rest.
Good morning. It's Saturday, and I will be shocked if I get a lot of footage today, because Saturdays are usually pretty hectic in our house. But I am hoping to go take Grayson to a playground this morning because it looks like the rain's gonna hold off. And then possibly this evening, Stephanie and I are gonna be doing reading sprints. It depends on if timing works out. So this is sort of a spur of the moment thought. So we'll see if it actually pans out.
Hello. The baby's sleeping. He's probably gonna wake up pretty soon. I'm off the floor. But then I have been for the last like hour moving pictures over to my computer. We had like a power surge at one point, I think, and it knocked our network drive completely off. So we don't have a network drive anymore. And so I'm 3 months behind on the photo book that I do every year. I try to do them each month. That has not happened. So I just moved August, July, and June's pictures over to my computer. I'm waiting on my husband to be able to get his over to something that I can access so that I can then like sort through them and pick the pictures that I want to do for the book and then actually do the book pages. So it's like a 3-step process or more, which makes it exhausting. But I love these books. They are amazing to look through and just, I don't know. I feel like digital photos are so impermanent that like I want a physical, tangible thing to look through. So that's that. I did read a little bit of The Feeling of Falling in Love today, and I'm really liking it. The main character is kind of a dick, but I think intentionally, and the way that the synopsis reads, we're gonna kind of figure out why he's that way. I am interested to get deeper into it and see how I feel about it.
That's okay. This morning I woke up, and it's Justin has Saturdays to get up with Grayson, so I'm like, I'm gonna lay in bed and play Animal Crossing and just relax. And I hear this tiny little voice say, "Ick, cat barf." And then there's like a pause, and then I hear very sweetly, "Maybe Daddy will clean it up." I could hear him running into the kitchen going, "Daddy, there's cat barf. There's cat barf in the playroom." He's just
Well, sprints were a lot of fun. I really should do that more often. And I got a lot read in my book. I got past the 100-page mark, so that was good. I am enjoying this quite a lot, so glad to have picked it up. But now I'm gonna go to bed because I'm gonna have serious regrets in the morning because it's almost midnight. So, whoops.
See one more picture of this.
Did that because I told Stephanie last night on the reading sprints that the number of times in these vlogs that I have to cut out me being like, so, I just had to. So I'm leaving the house. I am going to the pottery studio. I actually need to run back upstairs and get my other camera and my tripod. So I'm gonna do that real quick. But then I'm gonna go to the pottery studio and try to also go to the garden center. And if I make it to the garden center, that means when I come back, if it's not raining, then I'm gonna put some plants, fall plants, in the ground. So that is the plan. And yeah, we'll see how that goes. And I'm gonna listen to my audiobook of Tomorrow and Tomorrow and Tomorrow in the car. And potentially also while I throw, because I usually listen to audiobooks while I throw, but not while I carve and stuff, because when I carve, I sit around a bunch of people, so then I just chat. But yeah, time to go. Hello. I stayed at the pottery studio until almost 5 o'clock, which is when they close on Sundays, and I had no idea. I was just in a zone, and I actually felt really good about
like, not everything I made, some of it was just not cute, and I messed up a lot, but I actually felt really good about just like getting in a groove and actually being able to produce something, center things. It was very messy today, but the last time that I was throwing was a class about bottleneck vases. And like, I couldn't even center anything and I was getting super frustrated. So I was worried that I was just gonna have endless problems today and be frustrated, but I didn't. And I was able to apply the things I learned in that class. It was supposed to be a 2-week class and I had to cancel on the second week because of aforementioned entire family got COVID. But I got some really good tips in that first class and that teacher was incredible and I was able to apply those things. Oh, the lens is doing that. There we go. Apply those things. So I made some cool stuff, which I completely forgot to take any video of, I think. I might have had one video when I made a pumpkin. So I might have had one video that showed some of the things I made. So if so, you will have already seen it. But now I'm gonna go pick myself something up to eat. Thankfully, somebody brought bagels to the studio because I didn't realize how hungry I was until I was already there. And then I was like, crap, do I have to go back out? But there were bagels. But now, apparently my toddler wants french fries, so I'm gonna go get him some french fries on the way home, but I'll probably also get myself something. So that is the plan.
You hear something new going on.
Well, hello guys. It's 8:30 at night. I had to go to the office this morning and I was up at like 6 and yeah, vlogging didn't happen. I think I took like 2 clips today on my phone and that was it. But it was a really good day. I got to see not only my boss, but the other manager for the other half of the team. And my counterpart to that is for the other half of the team, who I've never met but have worked with for going on 4 years. And then I also got to see a friend of mine that has moved on to another job, but he came in because he'd never met my counterpart on the other team as well. So I got to see him for the first time in 3 years, which was super fun. So it was a really good day and I'm back at the office again tomorrow. And we're gonna go out and get delicious pizza. And yeah, so tomorrow is much more meeting heavy. Today there was a lot of chit chatting and a very little work getting done. But yeah, it's been a good, it's been nice. And but I got absolutely no reading done. I did, on the way home, go by the bookstore. And I got myself 2 books. And I got Grayson 2 books. So for Grayson, I got Hedgehogs Autumn Hide and Squeak, which apparently they're going to make. I have like the original Hedgehogs book, which we read all the time when he was really little, and he still loves that book. But apparently they make them as like different seasons, because it looks like on the back there's a spring one. And I love this. We read it tonight and he thought it was hilarious. And then we also got, I got this one because we're potty training, and Leslie Patricelli does another one called Toot, which he thinks is hilarious. So this is another one. And then for myself, first I picked up The List of Unspeakable Fears by J. Casper Kramer, because Jessica, who wrote this, is the wife of my former coworker from the TV station. So I adore her And this is her second book she wrote. Now I'm gonna have to look. She wrote The Story That Cannot Be Told, which was beautiful. And this one I hadn't bought yet because I think it's a little bit like middle grade horror, possibly. But I saw it at my local indie bookstore. There were quite a few copies because I guess she's teaching a class this semester and potentially this is on the syllabus or something, but yeah. So I saw it and I snatched up a copy of that. And then I got this one, which is called Agatha of Little Neon by Claire Mouchette. I feel like I should do like a reading books by authors named Claire because I tend to like love books by Claire authors. But I had seen this cover around and I don't know what I thought it was. But I read the synopsis and was super duper intrigued. So, yeah, I'm quite excited to read this one. And yeah, that's a little impromptu book haul. It was really nice to just like go in and browse, and it was pretty, wasn't super busy. And yeah, I love that little bookstore. I can't wait to take my friend and her daughter there when they come in next week. That's next week. So I'm gonna tuck into my book and read a bit now, but I may try to carry this vlog on into the week, depending on how long it is. I haven't tried to edit it, so I don't know how long it is. But we'll see. If not, then I'll see you guys next time. And thank you for watching. Bye!